So this three means transient is going to create three, at most three access points, which is activity locations at each side of the link. I will show you what it is later. And there are a lot of keys you can use, but they are all commented right now. So I go to output, and I just remove them. I remove all of them. Let me remove all of them. Another thing I want to do, I want to add, is called zoning. For zoning, I just mean, I think you already see the zones that I was defining in Corsim or in MSAM. These are zones. In Premix, in Transims, I'm also planning to do the same thing. In order to do zoning, I just need to define the centroid of each zone. So let me show you how to do it. And this will be an input file of this transient net, the next second step. So let me load this cross.shp. So I want to put one zone here, one zone here, one zone here, and the other zone here. How do I do it? I can just use this identify. Let me do it another way. So I want to teach you another way to visualize your node data. So we go to tools, add XY data. And in this way, we can display a table. Then we add the output, this table. Then we specify which field is equal to X, which field is equal to Y. And we change this coordinate system to UTM. In this way, we'll be able to visualize some XY data. So I want to create one zone here, and I use the identify tool to check its X and Y coordinate. And I can copy them using Control C, or right click something, Control C. So this is the first node, first zone centroid. Similarly, I can do it for other centroids. Third one, and the fourth one. There are some other ways to do this. I just do it manually today. So it will be ID X coordinate, Y coordinate, and area type, I guess. Let's see if it's correct. So the first zone ID is this one, first zone, it has error type 1. The second zone centroid is here, error type 1. The third one, fourth one. So I created a CSV file and I want to save it.
The third attribute should be Y coordinate.
Why?
Third attribute.
Oh, okay. Okay, let me do this later. So I save it into transient shun as input node. Node.csv. Input zone, sorry. It should be input zone.csv. This is Y. If we open it, we see it's not coded right. So, yes. what would be the problem of this one? So let's just see if transients can read it. In transients net, I have also provided this key called input/input_zone.csv. So I already removed all the output and I execute it. So we see it's recognizing all the four zones and it has created a lot of new tables. If we check these tables in the output folder, we're going to see a lot of CSVs. One thing I want to mention is called activity location. In this activity location, we see some entities that have X and Y coordinates. And each of them has a field called zone, which is the zone ID I just specified, the input zone. CSV. And these activity locations are the locations that attract or generate traffic in transients. So in transients, the trips are not happening between any zones. They are happening between activity locations. Each activity location has an accurate pair of coordinates. And it's belonging, it's attached to a link. And let me visualize them. So I still go to ArcMap. If I go to tools, add XY data, and select the table I just created, you see, these are the activity locations. And do you remember the max access point? For example, here is a link. So this link will have at most 3 activity locations on each side. So that's the way transients generates activity locations, by spreading them evenly, distributing them evenly on the links. And these locations are the places where vehicles may come from or go to. Okay, so this is different from other thing. And if I visualize it using labels by zone IDs, so you may still remember I put this place as the centroid of zone 1. This is the centroid of zone 2. And you can see how these activity locations are associated to those zones. So, for example, if transients creates an activity location here, you will search the closest zone centroid and assign the centroid to this activity location. Okay. So, if we have one zone, one OD pair, for example, 1, 2, 2, then this OD pair, any trip between this OD pair, may be randomly assigned an origin between these between these numbers, and randomly another destination between these points. Okay.
Within the same zone, trips are not generated between activity locations, right?
They are still generated between activity locations within that zone.
Within
if the zone is 1 to 1, it will be from here to here or here to there.
Okay.
They are all possible.
Why there are so many zone 3? Because they are close to zone 3 or?
I think because they are closest to zone 3.
Yeah. Why
because
is that?
Maybe there is a node here called zone 2.
Mm-hmm.
There is a centroid called zone 1. So maybe the zone 2 is too far away. So these are associated to zone 2, zone 3, I guess. So let me validate these. If I add no data, and xy data. So that's, you see, this is zone 2. Okay, this is zone 2. So this point is closer to this one, not that one. So it's associated with zone 3. Okay, so we finished this part. And we have output. And this is the network we can use. We are ready. We are already ready. And the next step is called intercontrol. Intersection control is used for creating those traffic signals, phasing plans, timing plans, and we can skip it for this time. The next step is called transit. Transit net is used for creating transit network. We can skip it today. Then the next step is called convert trips. In the convert trips, if you open this control file, you will see the input include the activity locations, process links. Process links are the short links connecting activity locations and parking lots. So in transients, each activity location, which indicates a building, will be connected to a nearest parking lot. So actually, they simulate the traffic in this way. A person, for example me, this is an activity location, and I go out of this building by my foot, by my feet. I walk to the nearest parking lot, and then I drive from the parking lot to another parking lot. Then I go down, go out of the parking lot, and walk to the nearest building. And that's how transient simulates the person's activities. Okay? So each activity location